Be seated. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. We have a king who is searching for you and for me. So often I think of myself as searching for God. I mentioned several weeks back about the God that I would like God to be. And one of those was that God would be more available to me, that I could hear his voice more often. And that maybe I was seeking him. The good news for us is that God is seeking us. And today we talk about Christ the King, Christ the Lord, Christ the Good Shepherd, Christ the Servant. But this concept of Christ the King, those who prepared the lectionary decided this would be the turning point in our lectionary readings from going from ordinary time into Advent, where in fact, during Advent, we anticipate the coming of our Lord, the coming of our King, the coming of our Savior. Now, I would like to think that in the United States of America, we could care less about royalty. Let me say that again. Susan, who is ducking down here, we could care less about royalty. Wrong? Could you say more about that, Susan, in your American voice? No? Okay. But the problem is, I'm wrong. Once. I'm wrong. I think Americans do care about royalty. I can remember driving out here. It was like 40 years ago. I was on my way out west. I think I was in Arizona. When Princess Di and Prince Philip were getting married. Oh my gosh, we were so excited. Oh, everybody was talking about it. What was she going to wear?
Excuse me, Prince Charles.
Oh, it was Prince Charles. I could care less. What year was that, Sue? What year did Diana and Charles get married?
I think it was in the
80s, wasn't it? I think it'd be 81?
81.
That's the year I was traveling down here. This is when I came through Wyoming, Yellowstone Park. And I picked up hitchhikers along the way. And as you know, I picked up a German hitchhiker, and he and I became great friends, and his son came and visited this last summer. But I picked up this one guy. He was so excited about the wedding. Oh! And I could care less. If that's the right expression. If Gary Hermanchek was here, he'd correct that. But in America, we believe, and Wyoming is so American, nobody's going to be my king. Nobody's going to be my lord. We pull ourselves up by our own bootstraps. Am I right? Hoo-yah, or go Bucks, or what is it you say here for the football team? Yeah, that, whatever it is, I could care less. Georgia won yesterday, hallelujah! And Auburn won yesterday, hallelujah! That's another story. Gosh, Jim, stay focused. Squirrel. What was I talking about? Royalty. I wonder what it is about Americans that do value royalty. I mean, they're paying attention to whatever his name is and his future queen. Name, Caitlin?
William.
William and Kate, okay. I could care less. But we seem to care about royalty. I wonder what that is. That may be our Anglican roots. It could be, as my wife and I were talking about this morning. By the way, Maureen, would you please stand up? This is my wife, in case nobody, she's not going to stand up. Okay. Thank you, Barb. Glad to have her visiting me, because let me tell you, she's the key to good sermons. I remember early on when I was writing these long, lengthy sermons, I'd hand it to her to review. Pow, pow, pow. She would just cross out almost all of it and then zero in on where the power was. So this morning I was checking with my theological consultant. And she thinks that we like the pomp and circumstance. That's why I'm dressed up so nice this morning. And there is a part of us that likes that. That likes that. You know, I just came to the end of my sermon, but I'm not ready to be there, so I'm going to say a few more things. But remind me that it just came to me here, and I'll remember what to say. We serve a king who says his people will serve him. We serve a king who tells the story. This is the only story in Scripture in the New Testament that describes what the last thing will be. We will not be judged by our correct theology or our correct liturgy. We will not be judged by what church we belong to. We will not be judged by our belief in God. We will not be judged by our faith in God. We will be judged, as someone said Wednesday morning, by how we love one another. Because that's what this parable is really about. It's about loving one another, loving our neighbors, the ones we know, the ones we don't know, as ourselves. We follow not a king. I think the closest thing in America we can come to is your boss. If your boss asks you to do something, usually you do it. If the bishop calls me out, I'm rector, I'm ruler here, I don't have to do what he tells me. Don't put this on the web. However, I say yes, sir. And I imagine most of us do that as well. What would Jesus tell us our job is? How would Jesus give us a star in our crown about what kind of good job we're doing? What do you think? How would he judge us? I don't know how they get by with these things. I can't see. How would he judge us? He would judge us by our love, correct? All right, here's the ending. Most important thing to remember. Two important things. One is, he is seeking you and me out every moment of eternity. He is seeking you, and he may be seeking you in the voice of the homeless, in the voice of the naked, in the voice of the sick, in the voice of the thirsty, in the voice of the hungry. That's how he may be seeking you. But I always want to add to that, there are spiritually homeless, thirsty, hungry, naked people that are also being sought by God. Listen for their voices. As I shared last week, I hope during the season of Advent, you will invite someone to church, but pray before you invite them. Pray that God will reveal to you who that person is or those people are that you would invite to church by the time Christmas Eve gets here. We serve a king who is a good shepherd. On Wednesday morning, we had this debate, are you saved by faith? Are you saved by your good deeds? Are you saved by love? And in the South, you're always asked the question, when were you saved? And my answer always, even though I can point to a time when my life was transformed, 2,000 years ago is when we were saved. And guess what? He died for the sins of the whole world. So the whole world, who is his family? The whole world is his family. And he says, when you've done it unto the least of these in my family, you've done it unto me. In another parable, the Lord says, I never knew you. And or, you never knew me. Let us let Jesus get to know us. Because it's out of knowing Jesus that we'll understand his orders. And from where does he issue his orders? We say in the scripture, he will sit on his throne and judge us. His throne. And he judges each and every one of us.